with fish oil, there are two omega-3 fatty acids that we need called EPA and DHA. You want both of those. And there's argument about what the best ratio is. We really don't know. But you probably want to take something like 3 or 4 times EPA to DHA. So look on the label of a product you're using. Make sure it's giving you both EPA and DHA and more EPA than DHA. So 2 to 3 grams a day. Some people complain that taking fish oil, they burp up a fishy taste. You can put the capsules in the freezer, and if you take them directly out of the freezer, they're less likely to do that. If you take them on a full stomach, they're less likely to do that. There's a product called Krill Oil that's made from the little shrimp-like creatures that marine mammals eat. It's bright red, it smells very fishy, but it's digested lower down and you don't burp up any taste with that. There's some concerns, however, about the sustainability of krill and the environmental impacts of that, so I don't know. For kids, you can get liquid fish oils that are flavored. Nordic Naturals makes a lemon-flavored one and a strawberry-flavored one. Believe it or not, they're quite palatable and they can be mixed with juices. I think it's very important to get this in the diets of kids as early as possible, and infants and fetuses. The influence of omega-3 intake on brain development in the fetus and the infant is profound. The cell membranes of nerves in the brain are mostly composed of DHA. And if DHA is not present enough in the mother's diet, in a nursing mother's diet, there's reason to think that the brain, the architecture of the brain is weak. I think this is a factor in conditions like childhood autism, in ADHD, in a tendency to bipolar disorder, in unipolar depression. The data here are very impressive on the effects of omega-3 supplementation on brain development in kids. And we've seen in our clinic very spectacular results in autistic kids with fish oil supplementation, and also kids with ADHD. There's a psychiatrist at the National Institute of Mental Health, Joseph Hibbeln, who studies this area and is one of the presenters at our nutrition conference. And he has, I mean, really, really a spectacular data from around the world showing correlations of tissue levels of omega-3, low tissue levels of omega-3 with homicide, with suicide, with violence. Amazing thing. I mean, direct correlation of murder rates in different societies with omega-3 levels. So I think the influence of these fats on our general health, both psychological health and physical health, is profound. And again, I'll just repeat, I think most people in our culture are deficient in omega-3 fatty acids, and supplementation with them is key to healthy aging, to general health. And it's both, you know, increasing omega-3s and decreasing excess consumption of omega-6s.